Okay, hello. Yeah, now the microphone works. Good morning, and welcome to another episode in our ongoing Gebel Adda burial shroud saga. I have tried to get another scan or better scan of the third shroud, the shroud of Komar. Now, as you may remember, Giovanni Ruffini, a colleague of mine, had made a scan of a photograph that was in the archives of the late Gerald Brown at the Sector Library at Oxford University. I think his archives have been integrated as part of the Oxyrhynchus Papyri Archive, and the Oxyrhynchus Papyri are a project that Brown was involved in. It's been in the news lately because some of the people involved in this project have been selling off papyri to the international market, which is of course scandalous, and it tells us something about how these things are maintained at Oxford University, which is shocking. I have been trying to contact both the Toronto Museum, the Royal Ontario Museum in Toronto, and the Sector Library to get a better scan of this photograph. The Royal Museum in Ontario, I don't know if they have another copy of this photograph, actually. The person, Magda Wozniak, who is working on the textiles, said that she didn't see any documentation of this shroud there. And the Sector Library says that, well, we cannot make any scans, it's only for people who work in Oxford. Then I put out a Twitter call, like, can anyone in Oxford help me? And nobody gave a fuck. And then I finally, through Twitter also, found another librarian who, as usual, was very friendly and helpful. And maybe she will be able to help me to get a better scan. But Giovanni, in the meantime, also contacted the Sector Library, and they were like, you want us to scan a photograph in an archive that's, you know, unorganized and in several boxes? We don't think so. So they're probably not going to look for it, which means that I will have to go myself to the Brown Archives at Oxford, which will actually be a fun exploration, which I can do once the UK is no longer the center of COVID in Europe. So for the time being, I decided I'm going to continue the edition of this text with the photo I have. And it's going to be painful and slow, but then at least I'll have a good basis and we can, you know, get this, hopefully this paper out with the edition of all four shrouds and shroud fragments that we have from Gebel Adda. So let's get started. All right, so here we see the work we did last time. We did the beginning, and as you can see, we have the, let's say, standard, part of the standard, quote unquote, prayer right here that we were able to reconstruct with the help of the second shroud, which I think is the shroud of Ululi, or who is this again? Gapoiapa. Okay. We were able to read some stuff in the beginning here and propose some reconstructions. Why is there no Gima here? Clearly, this is a Gima. So, first correction, this one should be here, and actually, it is the Gima that should be the top Okay, so right, so sorry, I'm of course not being very clear. This Gmail is here calling Jill Gula. Well, Omicron Epsilon Epsilon Lambda. If you know it, you can see the traces of it, so that's why all these things are dotted. And then that guy is also kind of vaguely apparent. So we get into the first part, and I remember marking this in yellow here so I could keep track of which material we had covered, and then there was some stuff at the very end with God and the Holy Spirit and the Son and so on line 25, so that's probably somewhere here, where we also, yeah, here, Nissa, Sarvata Nissa, where we also did a bunch of lines that seems to correspond with what's going on here. And so also, as you can see, in terms of line numbers, this more or less corresponds. So maybe, just maybe, things are also corresponding in the middle. Wouldn't that be nice? Now, we know that in the middle we have this whole section on your name is. Your name is of the light, your name is of the beginning, your name is of the completion, your name is of the spirit, your name is of the sun and the moon and the stars, which, you know, sounds pretty unchristian to me, but I kind of like it. Your name is of the light, your name is of knowledge, your name is of wisdom, your name is of love, sorry, is of love, is of wisdom, is of life, your name is of the entire world, da 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 da. And so I just wanna go to parts where things are readable. And as you can see, actually, this section here, you know, between line 20 and 30 is actually not that bad, right? So this is really badly faded. But we should be able to start here, and starting at line 20, you know, I read tongues, or at least tongue, and I read moss here, so maybe at the end of the line is cos. Nissin here. Right, so this, there may be like a possibility of reading. So let's read. Let's actually begin with these. Let's do a little bit of these beginnings here. So we have line 15. Starts with Gapoiapa. Then we have what seems to be Tau Lambda. We're just gonna mark a little bit beginning, so there's an enigma here, and then what is this? An alpha, something else. We have na. What do we have here? Three letters, and then something like. And here, okay, so here we are in the tongues part. So this is a genitive here. And then we have in, quite clearly, in, and then we have tau, alpha, a dotted engma. And there must be tau, alpha. Okay, probably also should put the alpha. And then there must be a sigma here. I feel very strongly about. Right, in tongues, da 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 da, and then that continues here, and oh my god, it's bad, but here is the word tongues again, in tongues. Here it is again. Impossible, difficult to see, but we have epsilon nu, stroke, tongues. We don't know yet, there may be an alpha here, but we would have to see the other ones. for the moment, I'm just going to do this. And then I know there is another one. Where was it here? It's all super vague. Then we have tones. Again, a bunch of things that are unreadable. And then I read sha here. That's the end of the line, isn't it? Sha. Would that be de? Would this be the sun? Are we here in the masha de? Possibly. Over here. Masha there, which means that then on the next line 19, very tempting, of course. Mashada unde, and then Winji could again. There may be de here, de, and then we have win, and then we have the canna here. And then the on makes sort of sense. Then it says nde on. But that means at the end of the line here, masha de, then should be u here. That actually fits. Gonna put it in for the moment. There's not enough here. Where is the owner? Here. It should be here. It's just terribly faded. Actually, where does this line end in any case? Maybe it ends a little bit further. This is just a giant. And that's definitely a possible reading. This delta epsilon nu. And then we have on, and then we have omicron epsilon, which is also quite clear. So why don't I just then impossible. this is in Thomas again, then what is this? Unclear. Superlinear, and then epsilon rho, it seems. Interesting that it's a similar mistake as here. One, two, three, four, five, maybe four to five letters. Cool. That's what it seems to say. It's very unclear also. One, two, three, maybe. Okay, line 20. Ah, okay, so we begin here with Thomas. So there should be an E in here. Must be. Still don't have a full verbal form. Yeah. Oh my god, line 20. Enira. And then we have Enira here. In Tangas. Ah, here we have a full one. In Tangas Enira. Eh. Here we have Enira, quite clearly. Or at least. Sigma also clear. In also clear. Trace of alpha enigma is completely unreadable. There is clearly a sign of na here. And what is this? In Thomas Enira. Is this the in cosmos? Yes, it is in cosmos. In cos. Totally. Because this is clearly an epsilon. Nu. Okay, so we have this. In Thomas Enira. Then I mean, this must be cos. I can see part of the kappa, but like the rest, I'm just gonna say it's this. And then we have second line mos. Right, 21 mos. Owatona. Oh my god, it is. This is just so good. Omicron. I'm just gonna do all of this. And then this ton is good. And then this in cosmos. Owatona. Oh my god. So this is the end. So we found the end of this thing. Can we work backwards? Because we know that before in cosmos Watana is angina. So is this also just... We have a G. G might here. But that's not enough. Because on this is... There's too much space here. This may be tongues. And here, maybe here, this may be tau. And then this is a na. Which means that that then would be unena. And it is unena. This is unena. Yeah. Omicron epsilon nu epsilon. Which means that then here we have intangis e, and this is the enera of the next one. So we should just supply this. Unena. I can see the enigma here, alpha tau before it, sigma here, epsilon there. In epsilon is completely gone, but I can trace of the nu here. How are we going to see that? Tau barely visible, alpha barely visible, engma quite well visible, but still gonna dot it. Sigma. How is it possible? Intangis, with a dot above. That's visible. New. Fine. Come on. This must be era, but this is just completely gone. And then da 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 na. So this is an era, and then we have maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7. Six or seven letters. I mean, it's angina would be great. I mean, there's a gema here, but there's something more here. Okay, so if we know that this is unena, can then the previous one be untna? And then we work backwards. Is that even possible? So let's see. We have the sun and the moon and everything here on. Da-da-da-da-da-da. They can na. Let's assume that that's indeed here. Let's assume this is na. we have Winjiri, Gudek, and maybe then this is Dek, and blah blah blah. Okay, fine. Period. That means that we have another Intangus here. Intang maybe here, or actually here. Right, that's what we saw. Intangus era, but then what is this? This is definitely not Umitna. So there's another word here. Is this Aart? No. This is a Kappa. This is something with three or something. But what? Okay, so in other words, this is not, it doesn't follow the order. I think that we can safely say. So the order in which these, in which this thing appears is different. And that's very interesting again, because like if this is like a hymnal part, your name is that, and then again we find that the orders differ from shroud to shroud. This is really what Alexandros and Damien and I have been claiming in a recent text on the hymn number for creatures, is that these hymns were really to be spoken and kind of written down from memory. So you on the one hand have parts that are written down from text, like a textual transmission, as in this part, for example, right? It's very similar across different shrouds, but then the hymnical part, let's say, here, has an oral background. It's really interesting. Right, so you just have a collection of these things. Then your name is that, and you kind of like rearrange them from memory. Which then also suggests that only part of the text of the shroud was standardized. And another part was up to the imagination of the scribe. So you kind of have a flexible format. Right, it's completely fascinating. Okay, good. So we now found, and it also fits, right? I mean, this is around line 20, and this is just slightly after line 20. So it just fits so nicely. So let's continue with line 21, because things get better. What do now? Okay, yeah, look at this. Anyara, yeah, this is to say, this continues correctly. Okay. Oatona. We can definitely read Nis. Nisi with double sigma. Right, so I read sigma, lambda, omicron, kappa, something. So sigma, lambda, omicron, kappa. Let's make it an alpha as in the other text, right? So I'm basically coming here. This is visible, omicron dotted, kappa quite good, alpha dotted. I don't even know if I can see the angle. No, I'm just going to reconstruct all this tongue slow, and then we should have in before it completely faded. Now, loka. Yes. And then we should have anyara here. We see the superlinear stroke of the alpha. This is really barely visible, but the knee, anyara, rho quite well. Alpha also good, alpha good. I mean, I'm gonna do all of this because it's ridiculous that we're even possibly able to read it. And then we should have something like ueno, uena, what is written here? This is clear. This is all very, very tentative. And then a letter that I really don't know what it is. And it doesn't look like an omicron. Then we have again intanges. This time quite well readable. And then our trail ends because, like, here we don't know anymore what's going on. And neither do we here. Oh, isn't that sad? That is totally sad. I was hoping we could, like, fill up this lacuna. That's really, really sad. Okay. So we have intanges. This tau is good. Alpha is good. This is obviously just my imagination. End of line. That is sad. A little bit sad, but we have that end part. Okay, not bad. Okay, now let's see how far can we get with this. So we have done this, so then we supposedly would find things about your son. On entodes. Well, is. Okay, fine. We have a bunch of stuff in the beginning. Then we clearly read on intot. On intot 2. Definitely another omicron. On in tot and then a letter, but it's the only and then a name and then alpha is here. So at least this we have. But then it would be logical if this is an omicron, then this must be an epsilon. Here, which means that that's also what we should supply here. I think 1, 2, 3, 23. Where is this at the beginning of line 23? 1, 2. Oh, where is that? This is peak now. So this is that line. Two lines down. In Akara, so that's the line above. So here, on and to. Yeah, omicron epsilon. That's what it must be. we can still do a little bit of nice work on this. That is so good. Home and go to. Yes, but then what? Okay, the question is what's coming after this, because here, as you can see, I don't know. And here we still have quite some letters, like Omicron, Epsilon. Then what I read is something like Epsilon, Iota, Sigma, Iota, Rho, Omicron, Epsilon, Sigma, like is this just Jesus or something? Correction. This your only flesh become some Jesus or something? Is this Epsilon Iota Eta Sigma Omicron Epsilon Sigma, and this is a mistake. Okay, can we read Jesus here? Yes, totally. This must be Jesus here too. Yeah, Susie. Yes, who see? Christos. Is this just Chris? Christos. Yes, who see Christos? That's what it is. And you're only. This is. Yeah, that's what it is. Maybe the diuresis? Is there a diuresis? No, there's no diuresis. Yeah, Zeus. Oh my god, this is so nice. Here, Iota, Eta, Sigma, Omicron, Epsilon, Sigma. Yeah, Zeus. Then this weird thing is a G. This is not so clear. G. Rho, Ipte, T, Vague. Omicron good, Sigma good, Jesus Christus the Keller. Yeah, okay, Jesus Christ we have. And so do we here. Jesus, this must be the Chi, Rho, Iota, Sigma. And then the Sigma here. Here we have a yota, it ends in a yota. Yes, who's he? Rho, not so clear. But is clear. Yota, sigma, tau, omicron should be reconstructed. Really not. I mean, there's a trace of a tau, maybe. But then, sigma okay, then what? On. I don't know, letter N, and then end of the line. Wow. I cannot believe it. I cannot believe this, that we can use Komar Shroud to reconstruct Gapoiapa. Extraordinary. If you look at this, it's like, look at this. And yet, it divulges its secrets. Now, on Antotu, where are we? Here. On Antotu. Yeah, and then this is Ayer. Something like that. This is one or two letters. Then maybe a row. One, two, three, four, Wallahi, as they say. Now, next line, this line. So we've had this whole thing about his own his flesh-born, whatever. It doesn't matter well, in any case, I don't even know what that means. Blah, 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 blah. We have Rigu here. Oh, look here. That's this. Figuka, and then Aika. Wouldn't that, yes. Yeah, that's what that part is. Okay, so let's start again randomly in the middle. Rigu, we can read. Rigu. A kappa vaguely, alpha vaguely. That's this part here. Boom. Then we also read una just before that. Right? That's clear. That's this. Una. Now what must be in the middle? Tau, alpha, engma, sigma. Una, and then it becomes very unclear what should be here, and it's unclear here too. this line. I read ooh. There are many oohs. Sila. Another gula. Maybe this is the Wesk. Gula Kirto. Yeah, that's this. That's this. Gula. I read Omicron Epsilon Sigma. Omicron Epsilon. Yeah. 1, 2, 3. Gula. Kappa Rho. Tau. I could read this. Kirto. Ra. I'm not so sure about this. Then I definitely can read this. Do. Do. Potato here. And, I don't know, 45 letters? Can do, so that falls what in here somewhere. Do one now. Do one now. Oh wait, am I? Which line am I? Ah, this should be on the next line. That makes sense. Yeah, otherwise there was not enough. Ah, that's why. Okay. Boom. Om. I think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ta. And then 1, 2, 3, 4. Maybe. 2, 4 letters. Then we have the line with the from this line. is clear. Iota dotted, kappa dotted t, iota. One, two, three, four, five. Three, four, five. Alpha, gamma, clear. Another letter, letter. Maybe another letter. Epsilon, letter. Is this A low? Oh, clear, letter, letter, letter. Then a whole bunch of nothing until this una. This. I think I'm going to stop here. I'm losing my concentration. But as you can see, you just have to fill in these two lines. And then we're done. Then we have connected this part with this part, and here as well. I mean, if you zoom out, look at this. It's a mess. When I first saw this, I thought it was a mess. All right. That's it. Alright, I think the next video will be again about the shroud, because now that I know that like it so closely follows Gapoiapa shroud, I really want to fill in all the gaps, or at least have the feeling that there's a continuity. A continuity which should be there. This is the fascinating thing. Yeah, so this there, I mean, the texts are nearly identical. That's really exciting. Alright. See you next time.